Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today's video is pretty highly requested, but I never wanted to film it because it gives me like 2016 vibes and I just didn't want to film it. But so many people have been asking for it, so here is my What's on My iPhone video. This is what my current case looks like. It's from the brand Wildflower, and I just got it off of Amazon. I'm pretty sure it's linked on my storefront, but it's called like Coffee Heart, I'm pretty sure. And I just love the brown heart design, but it's almost time for a new case. I've had this one on since like June, I think, right before I left for Hilton Head. So I'm pretty sure that was in June. It's getting a little bit beat up, but it's still working for now. I have the iPhone 12 Pro Max. A lot of people always ask what phone I have because I normally take iPhone photos for my Instagram, and I just have the iPhone 12 Pro Max. I have the one with like 256 gigabytes, I think, is like the storage number on it, but I know it's like the biggest storage that you could get, and I do love this phone. I love like the three cameras on it, and it takes really, really good photos. I have the black one. I'm not gonna take my case off because it's like kind of a pain to get on and off because the outside of it is really protective, so it's kind of hard to get on and off, but it is the black one, or like the really dark gray. I think it's black though. My lock screen is just this photo of Johnny and I. We got these taken in California this summer by Zoe Isabel Photography. Her photos are so good and I love her editing. So I just really like this as my lock screen because it's like really bright and white. I just don't really like dark lock screens or even home screens really. It just makes my phone feel like super dark. So this is my lock screen. I'm obsessed with this picture. And then I do have the Face ID on this phone, which I love not having a home button. Ever since Apple has done those updates, it's just so much easier and I love it. So when you open my phone, the home screen looks like this. First, let me just start with the top and just kind of work my way down. I use Widget. I'm pretty sure what the app is called. Widgetsmith. That's what the app is called to use for all of my little widgets. That's what I use. So the top one is a calendar. I love just having that on my home screen so I can see what day it is and see the whole month there. It's just really helpful for me, especially when I'm planning out stuff. Instead of having to go find the calendar app, I can just open my phone and it's all right there. And then the widget under that, I know it's really, really small, but it says a lot can happen in 3 days. I'm a Christian, and so Jesus died and then rose 3 days later. So that's like the meaning behind that. But I feel like for me, it's just such a good reminder that whatever is going on like today and like in your life, a lot can change in just 3 days. So just keep going forward, you know, take it day by day because a lot can happen. So that's a really sweet, simple reminder that I love having on my home screen there. The apps that are on my home screen are my most used apps that aren't social media, just because it's so easy for me to get on my phone and go to Instagram, TikTok, and things, so I don't really like having those on my front page. So I just have FaceTime there because I use FaceTime all the time, and then my maps, clock, because I'm always setting alarms, you know, to wake up, and then my camera. Right under that, I have a widget. I'm not actually sure where that photo is from. I think I saw it on Visco a while back, and I was like, I love that photo. It's just like happy vibes. There's palm trees, the sun is setting. I just love it, and it goes with my whole aesthetic here. Then next to that, I have Safari. I always use Safari. I don't ever use Google Chrome. I know a lot of people love Google Chrome, but I just use the Safari app. And then I have the weather, my mail, and then my Gmail. So my mail app is a lot of like personal emails. Like when I buy things, I always send my shipping information to that email, or if I'm signing up for rewards with things and just other personal stuff, I always use my like iCloud email, which is what that is. And then my Gmail one is only like for work stuff. So when I work with brands and everything, I only give them my Gmail. On the bottom, I have just apps that I use all the time, which is my music app, my photos, my phone, and then messages. And I actually have, if you like swipe to the right on my phone, just a blank screen, because I just love having a blank screen there. Because sometimes when I shut my phone off, I will like leave it on, sorry, you can see like the reflection on my window, but I'll just leave it on this blank screen so that when I'm opening my phone, say I'm just like answering a text message or something, I don't want there to be like a ton of clutter, and I get overwhelmed really, really easily. Well, overwhelmed really, really easily. So sometimes I just like to have a blank screen there, and then as soon as I open my phone, it's just blank. But so then there's the first screen that I normally have it on, and then you swipe over again. Here is my next screen. At the top I have the time that the sun is setting or the time that the sun is rising. So right now the next thing that will happen today is the sun setting, so it's telling me it's gonna set at 7:25 p.m. I'm just a big sunset and sunrise person. And also for photos, you know, when you're trying to get photos before it's dark, or if I want to take photos at sunset, I just like to know what time it is. I can just go to my screen right there, it's right there for me. But then after 7:25 p.m. it will change to like what time sunrise will be. So this is the screen where I keep all of my social media that I use like almost daily, or at least every week. So first I have Lightroom, which is where I edit my photos and where my presets work. And then I have the Tezza app, which is where I edit videos for TikTok or Instagram stories, YouTube app. Then I have Unum. So this app is really cool. If you don't have Unum or anything like this, it basically just shows your Instagram grid here. And then you can plan out what posts you're going to post next. So you could like click on this one, click replace, and then it will just have different photos that you could choose. Obviously, I wouldn't post that. It's something I put on my story earlier. But then there's just different photos there that you can choose, so you can see what looks good on them. And then you can like rearrange the photos too. So this is really helpful for planning out your Instagram feed. Next line, I have Visco, Twitter, which I don't use Twitter as much anymore. Does anybody like really use Twitter? In like high school and middle school especially, I used to tweet like every single day. And I don't think I've used Twitter maybe like once a year. I'll get on there and just type something, and I've lost so many followers on there, I think, because I'm just so inactive on there. But it's just my least preferred social media platform. Next, I have Instagram and TikTok, then Pinterest, Snapchat, GroupMe. I used GroupMe a lot in college because that's what my sorority used to talk in all the time, was GroupMe, but I actually don't use that super often anymore. Next, I have Facebook Messenger, Telegram, which I use a lot for brands, like communicating back and forth, the App Store, because I'm like obsessed with updating my apps. So if there's a little notification there, like I'll go and update my apps. Sometimes at night even, I will just get on there, see if any of my apps need updated, and then I'll like let them update while I'm sleeping or whatever. I don't know. I just love my apps being up to date, I guess. But then next to that, I have Facebook and then Gumroad, which is what I sell my presets on. So this will just like keep track of how many sales I've made today, monthly, yearly, things like that. Then on the next screen, if you swipe over, I have a widget up here of a picture of Johnny and I. I actually have this picture hanging up in my bedroom too, because I just love this photo. It's so sweet, and I feel like it's very like Pinterest-y, and if you didn't know that it was us, you would just think it's like random people almost. It looks like one of those photos. But so then next to that, I have apps like grouped together, and I have a little money sign. So in there I have the Bank of America app, and then Venmo, PayPal, Amex for my other credit cards, Cash App, Wallet, and then Merchants was my old bank, but I actually closed that account, so I don't really need that app anymore. Next to that is this little like tool settings thing that I have grouped together. These are just some of the Apple apps that I have on my phone that I still want on my home screen and not like remove from home screen. You know how you can take some apps off your screen completely? So I still want these on there, just they're not as important. So I have Reminders, Calendar, Notes, Calculator, Contacts, Settings, Find My. I use this for Find My Friends a lot. And then I have Zoom. And the next little grouping together one is like my food and drink that I use pretty often. So I have Grubhub, DoorDash, Uber Eats, Starbucks, Dunkin', Chipotle, and Dutch Bros. And the other little grouped together one, it's just a heart, but it's all my shopping stuff. I just don't really like the little shopping bag emoji. The colors don't really go with my whole theme, so I just use the white heart. So in there I have the American Eagle and Aerie app, Shein, Sephora, Amazon, Luxor One, which is like what my apartment complex uses. If we get packages in the mailroom, it will like send me a notification, and I'm not logged in, so I can't even show you. Next is the Fort Worth parking app. I use that all the time if I'm going downtown. It's just so easy to get on there and park instead of like going to a parking meter. Target, Flip Fit, and then the Shop app. Right under that I have my music, so it always does like my recently played music. Of course there's Lainey, Taylor Swift, and then My worship playlist is on there too. But I think that this widget looks so, so cute with the music and like the pinkish color. So cute. Under that, I have the Knot, which is where me and Johnny's wedding registry is through. And so I can get on there and just like track our gifts and people who have RSVP'd, things like that. It's so nice. It says 90 days to go at the top with a little countdown. Yeah, there's a lot on here that I don't use, but there is a lot that I use too. Next is the WhatsApp. So I use that also for communicating with brands back and forth. Then the Like to Know It, and then Like to Know It Creator, because I recently made a Like to Know It account, if you didn't know that. So you can shop some of my outfits on there. I'm still pretty bad at like putting all of my outfits on there, but there is some stuff on there. Then next to that, it's just another picture one that says mean people are ugly. I just like that. And I feel like too, it's super good to remember, especially me who's like on social media actively, like when people comment really mean things, like I just need to remember they're not actually ugly, but it's like they have no clue about my life and they're just commenting on some random person's stuff saying rude things. So it's like, who's the bigger person in this situation? And that's just a really good reminder to me. So then after this page, you just swipe over and there's like all of the apps that I have. I like how Apple groups these together too, and it's like social, creativity, productivity and finance, utilities, travel, entertainment, shopping and food, other, information and reading, games, health and fitness. So I just love having those groupings there, and so it's like apps that I don't necessarily need on my home pages, but apps that I still want to have on my phone. I know that a ton of people do like the really cute app things where it's like all of their apps are really aesthetic photos, but honestly that just stresses me out a little bit. I just like knowing what app I'm clicking on, and I know you can make them like look really similar to the app with just like a cute cream color or pink or whatever, but like I said, I get overwhelmed super easy, and so that would just stress me out having a ton of different apps, and I would get so lost on my own phone. So all of mine are the regular apps. Just if they don't really look cute, I will just put them in here where I don't have to see them all the time, but I know that they're like still on my phone. Also, I'm pretty sure that whenever you do that, you have to click on your app and then it goes to the app that you use to change it and then to the app you're trying to get to. And I know that would just stress me out really badly too. So all of my apps look what they look like when you download them from the App Store, but to me it looks really clean and cohesive, so I like it like that. Also, I thought it'd be fun to just like show you my Apple Music playlist that I have, because I think that the little pictures for them are so cute. So there's a country playlist. There's not a whole lot in there, but I do listen to like a little bit of country. Nothing crazy. It's mostly Morgan Wallen. Then the I Like Being Alone But You Might Be the Exception. So that's just all songs that are like love songs, just like a lovey playlist. Then I have In the Car. It's kind of like a road trip vibes playlist. These are songs that the lyrics aren't like super, or they're not like pounding songs. They're just like really chill vibey songs, you know, for when you're on a road trip or something. Next is Jams, which is basically all like pop songs. You need to get in your car, you're just driving somewhere and you just want to listen to fun upbeat music. This is the playlist. Next is Jesus You're Cool. That's my worship playlist. There's a ton of songs in there, but that's worship. And then Late Nights is exactly what it sounds like. Late nights if you're driving late at night. I feel like in college I was like driving late at night, or me and my friends would go places late at night. Here lately, not so much. You know, I'm a dog mom. We don't go anywhere super late. So I don't really listen to that one anymore, but it's still a good playlist. Let's Go Dancing in the Street. It's just, there's not a whole lot of songs in there. That's my newest playlist that I've made, but it's just like dancey songs, if that makes sense. I don't actually know if that makes any sense. Lil Baddie, those are, it's exactly how it sounds, Lil Baddie, you know? That's like a girl's playlist, basically. If you're a guy, you probably don't wanna listen to that playlist. Real Feels is the next one, just In My Feelings type songs. Summer Vibes, those, it's exactly how it sounds, which is basically what they all are, but just a summer playlist. Wedding playlist, that's songs that we're playing at our wedding. There's some like upbeat ones for dancing, and then some like slower ones that I want when people are walking in and stuff like that. And then my workout playlist that I haven't updated in a really long time actually, but it's still there. So that's it for the what's on my iPhone video. Hopefully this was the video that everyone was expecting. I swear every time I post a YouTube video, there's always someone who's like, can you do a what's on my iPhone, or people DMing me on Instagram like, what does your iPhone look like? So I hope that this is exactly what you're looking for. I feel like some people's look so cute, but I feel like mine looks cute, but it's just very like me and set up to how I like it. So I hope that you guys like it too. If you did, please be sure to like and subscribe and leave me a comment on this video, and don't forget to follow me on Instagram. I'll see you in the next video. Bye guys.